نجم بوليوود شاروخان ضيف خاص في تريندينج. We are honored to have in the studio with us today the Bollywood star, the mega star, Shahrukh Khan. Welcome to Trending. Welcome.
Thank you very much.
We are so happy to have you today. And my first question, it will be about your Arabic promotional tour about the movie Zero that will be released on 21st of December. Tell us more about this exciting project.
First of all, to be in UAE and you know, showcase the film here is always wonderful. It's always wonderful to be with NBC.
Thank you.
You guys are really wonderful. Thank you very much for having me once again. It's a different kind of film. It's about a film which, you know, in all our lives, we kind of believe that we want to reach perfection. We want to be right. We want to be good looking. We want to be healthy. We want to be the best. But me and the director, Anand Rai, and the writer, Himanshu, we felt that Allah wanted us to celebrate our incompleteness. He didn't make all of us complete. There's something amiss in all of us. And I think it's a wrong thing to keep on looking for, oh, I'll be as good, oh, I'll be the best, I'll be the tallest, I'll be the fairest, I'll be the darkest, I'll be the thinnest.
Or the perfect.
So, or perfection is, I think, only in God and nature.
Yeah.
So we should start celebrating our incompleteness. So Zero's about a vertically challenged person who doesn't ask for empathy or sympathy. It's about a girl who's got cerebral palsy. Mm. And it's about the most beautiful woman in the world who's emotionally incomplete, which is played by Katrina. So it's just celebrating incompleteness, and it's
so
a fun
film. It has a very strong message.
It has a message, but we tried not to make it like a preaching.
Too much, yeah.
Yeah, it's just funny and it's sweet, and hopefully everybody will see that, oh, it's all right to be incomplete, and we are best as we are.
Yes. This is such an exciting news, and we know that you will continue on your promotional tour tomorrow in Kuwait and Oman. But as you said, we want you to tell us a little bit more about the role that you're playing, because we know that this is the first time ever that you play a very different role, and we know all the roles that you play are very challenging. But this one is a little bit, as you said, more challenging because it is about a small person in a scale. So how did you prepare emotionally to play this role?
It's technically very challenging, one, you know, because there's no scene in the film which is not shot with me. So you have to make me 4 feet 5 inches tall. And so all the sets are dug up in a different way. All the other actors, and we have scenes on the Times Square in New York. We have scenes in Meerut, which is a very crowded city in India. So, you know, to work with thousands of people, cars and scooters, and they all have to, we have to create roads which are bigger. And I have to walk on the ground. So all the cars and hundreds of people have to roam around, and we build, you know how you have Lego?
Yeah.
So big Lego boxes where everything moves higher than me. So that part is technically very challenging. But apart from that, you know, I don't know, I've, you know, when I do a scene in the film, when I become smaller, it just gets a life of its own. It's not like me.
It's not like you.
It's not like me. As a matter of fact, when you know, normally when we make a film, then we go out marketing it and talking about it. So everyone tells you do a song from the film, or you know. And so I feel awkward doing it because I somehow feel it's not me. That was one. Second, also, you know, to somehow have such less in life, you know, when you are physically or vertically challenged like this, to still keep a happiness around you.
Yeah.
You know, otherwise you can get cynical and you can be mean. Mm. And he's all that. He's all that. But still, I'm hoping that people will love him a lot in spite of all his weaknesses. Because you will find something about you in him.
He's very confident.
Fantastic characters or whatever.
No. Yeah, it's quite brilliant. It's quite brilliant, you know, because when I'm doing scenes and all the girls watch the film at the office and they say, oh, you can't be so mean. You can't be so bad. You're always so nice to everyone. And then, you know, at the end of the film, they're like, but we still love you.
I have a technical question, actually. I know you've mentioned a little bit about how playing that character was sort of challenging, but was there any special effects, anything used to sort of make you seem so small?
Yeah, not on sets. On sets, all the actors had to imagine me small. So Katrina and Anushka and lot of others.
Yeah.
And for them, it's, you know, there's a scene where Katrina bends down and kisses me or hugs me. So for them, it's a little odd. They've known me for, you know, 15 years.
Yeah.
And they're like, and they're tall ladies. They're very tall themselves. I'm, I think, shorter than them otherwise also. But to be this short, It was a little awkward for them, you know, to relate to me. But technically very challenging because I have to do the scene at least 5 times, the same scene.
Wow.
So if I've done a scene that, say, if I say, I love you, then I have to do it with my arms out. Then I have to do on a smaller ground. Then they have to take my face also. So it takes very long. It's, very,
wow.
it's taken us nearly
different,
2 years.
Yeah. Angles to make you look
yeah,
so
and
small.
And, it's, and also the props. So if there are papers like this, you'd be carrying this. I'd be carrying a little bigger paper. My
oh,
iPhone
change
is
the
a
scale.
Little bigger. Yeah, to change the scale. So there's forced perspective. Mm. There's set design. And then there's a lot of visual effects, which has been done by our home company, but really this wonderful set of boys, Harry and Ketan. Arjun, they're in Red Chilies VFX, which is, this is the first time in the world somebody's tried something like this.
That's amazing. Also, we have to mention the director, Anand El Rey, that you worked with. How was your experience working with him?
Oh, he's fantastic. He's, you know, when you're doing shows and you have directors and if they allow you to be yourselves and say, present the news, you know, update it the way you wish, and you know, obviously you have to keep certain elements in mind. Mm. Besides that, he's very free, and he's completely opposite to me. He's very talkative.
Yeah.
He's very amiable, and he's very social. I'm a little reticent and quiet.
Really?
I am, and I'm shy. But he's outgoing, and he loves food. So for him, whatever the shooting is happening, if today's food is good. Shooting
everything
is
good.
Everything is good.
I already like this person.
He's lovely. I wish I could.
I'm like him. That.
You mentioned also Anushka Sharma and also Katrina Cave that they are co-stars in this movie. Can you tell us more about their roles?
Yeah, I think Anushka started with me 10 years back. Her first film was with me, and Katrina also. I think she'd been working in films for 2-3 years. And see, they're very close friends of mine. I love them. They love me back. And this is very challenging for both of them, you know. And as a matter of fact, when we got onto the film, we hadn't completed the story. And this is a film like, you know, in theater, when you are trying to make a story as you go along. We knew the story idea.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
you know, to do the specifics. And some other actors also were approached, not in the lead roles. And a lot of them said, look, oh, you don't have a story. We don't want to do this. I'm extremely thankful to both of them, apart from being my friends and loving me, and I love them. You know, to have the confidence in the director and the writer and say, listen, we are coming along for this ride. You know, it's an expensive film. It's going to take 2 years of your life.
Yeah.
And you're not too sure where it's headed. You know, will my... Normally heroines are, oh, my role is better or her role is better.
Because it's different.
It is different. And I think I'm extremely thankful to them to, you know, have the trust and say, listen, we'll come for the ride. And truly they believe, there's a saying I believe in as an actor, that there are no small roles, only small actors.
Yes.
So I think
yes.
Katrina and Anushka are really big actors to have
well
participated
said,
in the film. Yeah.
Yeah.
There's also something that we are very excited to talk about, which is actually the songs. We know that the first song that has been released, it was with Anushka Sharma and it was Mera Nam Tu. And the song was very romantic and a very beautiful song and everyone loved it. But on Tuesday as well, we heard the second song, which was Izaki Bazi. And it was a hit on social media and everyone was talking about it, even over internet. The views were over 17 million in less than 24 hours, which is amazing. We saw Salman Khan with a special appearance. But we have a question. Why isn't he in a main role and only in a special appearance?
He doesnn't have time.
He doesn't have time. He's busy.
He came, he was very sweet. We were all sitting and we were in my house, the director Anand and Himanshu. And we were just playing some pool and discussing. We have to do the song. And I got a call from Salman. This was at 2 a.m. in the morning. Salman and me meet only at nights. So he called me and he said in his inimitable manner, what are you doing? So I said, I'm just sitting. He said, I've got 2 cycles for the children.
Oh.
Cycles? He said, yeah, I'm sending. Actually, I'm coming over. So I said, yeah, I'm in a meeting. He said, it's okay, I'll come. I'm bringing 2 cycles. So he got me, he got 2 cycles. He rode the cycles and came. So he's got a company called Being Human. Social service company.
Mm-hmm.
And he came in the cycles and he sat. And he said, what are you guys doing? So he said, we're discussing, we have a song and, you know, we wanted a big movie star to be part of it. He says, bigger than me?
Oh.
I said, no, not bigger than you. So he said, then I'll do it. When you want to do it? So
that's
we were
nice.
Not even ready. And we says, when are you free? So he said, I'm free 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th. So please do it then.
So
we
he
put up
offered
the set.
It.
Yeah, and he had heard the story before from Anand. I think the idea, he must have met him somewhere. He really liked it. And of course, he has his own way of shooting. And he told me, don't do it yourself. Get a duplicate to do it and all. I said, no, I'd like to do the whole film. It'll take us some time. And this was 2 years ago. We shot the song 2 years ago, what you saw. And he said, okay, I'll be there.
Really?
And, yeah, and he just came and shot the song. So really sweet of him.
That's really
and,
sweet.
And he really believes in the film. He thinks it's very different. It's very cool. And he had some ideas also of the story and things. So he's been...
well, supportive, you can say.
Yeah, very supportive. Yeah. And yeah, like you said, he wasn't there for 2 years. Otherwise, he would be playing my role and I would be just doing the guest appearance.
But it's really, really nice. I love the song.
Yeah, and we have a next one coming, which is also very nice, which is Katrina's song. It's called Husn Parcham, which means... declaration of my beauty.
Ah.
Husn is beauty, Husn. Yeah. And Parcham is a flag.
So in addition to Salman Khan, we will also see the late Sridevi in a special appearance. And it was the last scene she filmed. So can you tell us about her?
Yeah, yeah. There's a sequence in the film where the director wanted that I meet all the actresses I've worked with in my whole career of 25 years. And obviously, I did one film too, with Sridevi. It was actually a small role. It was called Army, where I was a husband. And then I die, and she takes revenge for my death. And then she's, I think perhaps it would be right to say, one of the best, the biggest of superstars that Indian films have seen. A really wonderful lady.
She is. God rest
really
her
wonderful.
Soul. She's amazing.
And, you know, so I just called all of them, and I've not spent so much time with Shiri because I just did one film with her. The other actresses, some of them I worked with many films, and I remember she was the first one. She says, yes, I'm coming. And she came, and she spent a lot of time on the sets, and you know, it goes to I have a lot of wonderful memories with her, but one of the finest qualities is that even though she was there for a little while, just a day of shooting, and I remember when she was leaving, which was we were shooting nights, so we started late at about 7 in the evening, and we won't go on till about 4 or 5 in the morning, and it's a hectic shoot. And at the end of it all, she's like, "Can I come and dub my scenes?" And she was so wonderful. Sweet. So really sad to, I mean, I miss her dearly because you know, she's one of the first big actresses who gave me an opportunity to work when I was a newcomer.
That's amazing.
So hopefully,
it's a big loss, actually.
It's a huge loss, and
but I mean, she lives on through all the movies and
yes, she
all
does,
the,
and in our hearts, and inshallah, when we see her in the film, it'll just remind us of how wonderful and beautiful.